Hello guys, welcome to my channel. If you guys are new, I am Sophie. Alright, so my morning routine consists of making my bed. I love this 5-minute journal, and I have my to-do list one also. So I write in both of those, sit in here, put on my slippers. This is today's quarantine outfit, cozy. This is from Storitz. And then I'm gonna go grab my coffee. I like this oat milk. My milk is Throft, my oat milk. Pour some of it on here. Grab my coffee. And I go over to my little living room. It's raining today. It's pouring. Another part of my morning routine is we like to listen to this radio in the morning. Headed down to my deck, and this is where my workout spot is gonna be.
I loved it when you smiled. I loved it when you asked, can I stay a while? I can't believe I hurt you. I loved it when
Luke came to say hi during my workout. That's it for my workout. I'm quarantined, everyone is doing live workouts, so I'm out of breath. But it really helps to be able to work out from home, and I'm so lucky to have this view. Alright, so I just finished my workout, and today I decided to do a self-tanner. I'm doing Saint-Tropez tan because it's time and I'm so pale, so I just put it on. Gonna let it sit for a little bit. I'm gonna have my Smarty Pants gummies that I have every morning. And then I'm gonna get ready for the day. So I'm gonna do some emails. And then I'm gonna get ready and maybe film a few TikToks. Fun quarantine life. So yeah. All right, so it's 10:30 and I just made myself a little acai bowl. I have some granola, grain-free granola, and banana, coconut on top, and some almond butter on top. Inside is an acai packet with half a banana, some strawberries and berries, and some collagen protein powder. And that's it. Now, this is my little work setup. I'm here every day, and I get this beautiful view. And some birds came today. Finally, guys, I got two birdhouses. The first one didn't work on the right, but the second one worked. The birds are here. I'm gonna return the other one. When they come, I will show you the little birdies. Birdies are here. So I kinda wanted to do a little unboxing with you guys today. First up, we have no idea who this is from. Literally, oh, it's 437 Swimwear. Really cute swimwear brand. They sent me this little suit. Oh, I'm so shooting this weekend. Oh my god, so it's actually like a straight up thong. But it's that ribbed material that I really, really like. And also, they sent me the top. Also kind of a ribbed material. And they also sent this adorable pink little terry cloth skirt to wear on top of that suit. So adorable. So excited to wear that. Next up we have something from Princess Polly. So I have these little glasses that are really cute, which I now have in like 100 different colors. These little straight across frame, really chic. I feel like they're like my go-to pair recently.
They're just like a good staple. I didn't select these items, so I think that she sent me someone else's package because I didn't select any of this, but it's cute nonetheless. This is adorable. This little blue shirt matching what I'm wearing now. I didn't choose this either, but I could wear this on top of something. It's like a little corset. Usually you wear it like on top of like sweaters or like shirts or like dresses to kind of give it a different look. This little top too. This little polka dot top, also cute. Didn't choose it. Sorry, this is not stuff I picked, but really cute still. I love the ribbed side. It's like all ribbed and then it has the ruched detail and it's like a tank dress. Really adorable. This is Lioness. Next we have the skirt, which is so cool, but it's like cray. It's like buttoned all the way down and has these little buckles. Really cute. Definitely don't know how I'm gonna style that though, but we'll see. I got this pink skirt. How cute this is. So cute. I'm obsessed. I want to like wear that today. I think I'm going to shoot that today. Oh, and I also got the same one in blue. The little blue one. So cute. I can't ever choose which color is my favorite. This blue or the light pink. I always go to blue, but I really love light pink too. These are probably like my two favorite colors and I can never choose which one. So I'm so indecisive that I got both. Crazy is what you call me. So this is really cool from Lioness. This is a dress with like the sleeves. Well, this is probably post-quarantine, but I'll probably put that corset on top of it. That could be really cool. What's up next is, oh, they sent me these ragged jeans, but this time in black. And I also got other rag jeans and they have like a butt rip, these ones though, which is so cute. Yep. Also have them in denim also. So she sent me this really cute little top. I love this white top. I'll wear this with like everything, probably one of those skirts. And this little Lioness top with ties, cute for summer. Little top. Oh my god, it's like a little corset top. This would be really cute with the skirts I showed you guys. It's like a blazer. From Lioness. Like a blazer dress. That's also cute. This is like, I'm gonna have to wear all this stuff after quarantine. So I got this from Brogio Hair. This little kit. They have a scalp revival conditioner, a dry shampoo, scalp treatment, and this little brush. So that's kind of cool. Nick is trying to do something next to me. Her house wasn't so small. We wouldn't hear each other. I just threw this on to be a little cozier. I am going to continue unboxing with you guys a few more packages. This one is from Laura Mercier. Let's see what they sent me. Pretty cute. They wrote me a little card that says my name on it. How adorable. Very cool. They picked out something for my skin regimen. And then this little Laura Mercier package. And it comes with this little bag. Cool. A eye makeup remover, a lip stuff, hydrating lip stuff, a multi-skin moisturizing thing, and a cleansing oil, nourishing rose oil, and illuminating eye cream. Package from SEL. They're so fun. I thought that these would be really cool for spring. We'll see how I style them. Okay, this jacket is so adorable. Look at this jacket.
And the best thing about it is it has like these ties on the sleeves, which is so adorable. And it comes with these matching pants. So that's a look. Oh, I love this. So it's just like a all sleeveless shirt. And it has a ruched ties on the side. So this would be good like with sweatpants or anything just to kind of spice it up and change it up a little bit. So it's like a jersey tee. It's kind of just like this, but it'll be really cute with necklaces, and I'm thinking like big jeans, kind of just another casual thing. I got that in white also. Next is from Storitz. How cute is this little cropped blazer? Really into cropped blazers for spring. I think they will be really trending and cute. And then I got this matching skirt to go with it. This little tennis skirt vibe is also a huge spring trend. So that's like a set together. Really cute. And I also got like this other, this is another blazer. It's like this and it has a buckle. So the buckle will go around the middle to kind of cinch the blazer. I got these Levi jeans. They're the ribcage jeans because they are supposed to be a really good fit. They're tight here and then they flare out at the bottom. They're a little big. I ordered one size too big, but they actually feel okay right now, but I'll probably put them in the dryer if I need to. Shrink them up. But they're a cute black jean. Alright guys, that's it for the unboxing, and on to the next thing that I'm doing during quarantine. So for dinner tonight, I am doing a vegan Alfredo pasta. So I am steaming the cauliflower right now. I'm going to put the recipe here for you guys, but you do 1/2 cauliflower head, 1/2 cup of cashews. We soak them both in hot water, and I'm using this pasta tonight. And you're gonna need a little milk for when you mix these in the food processor with some garlic. That's all it is. Cauliflower, cashews, garlic, and a little bit of almond milk or oat milk or whatever you have just for liquid so it can mix. And I decided to do some broccoli also with garlic and onions and the red lentil pasta in the back cooking, gluten-free. So once the Alfredo mixture is done in the food processor, I will add it into this. All right, so we have the cauliflower, the cashews, the garlic, olive oil, and a little bit of milk, and we're gonna mix it up. This is what it should look like after, and now I'm going to combine it with the other ingredients. Just mixed all the ingredients together, and it is so thick and creamy. We're gonna serve up now. And the deck tonight, and voila, Alfredo is served. Vegan Alfredo. Today is a cloudy morning. It's bring your fiance to work out with you day. So I am making the TikTok whipped coffee this morning. Finally figured out how to do it. You do need a whisk, instant coffee, I use coconut sugar for a healthier version, milk, and hot water. 2 teaspoons actually of instant coffee, but me and Nick are both gonna have it this morning, so I'm gonna do like more than that, kind of a bit. 2 of the coconut sugar. Get our handy dandy whisk, and it takes about probably like 3 minutes to get it really whisked. You can see that. Fill these up with oat milk. And you kind of just like get that through.
And that's it, whipped coffee.
Hello guys, me and Nick are on our way to the grocery store. It is Saturday, the sun is out, it's been so gloomy, but today the sun is out and that's super nice to have that for a change. Even though we can't do much, we're gonna go to the grocery store and then but first we're gonna go pick up some food from Great White in Venice. Nick's getting a breakfast burrito. I'm doing avocado toast. Yeah. Anything else to add?
I covered it all.
All right, let's go get some yummy food. We've been so sick of eating the same old food. We keep on like making the same meals. But on the weekends, we treat ourselves to eating out.
Streets are empty.
Where else to eat, so we have to eat in our cars, but.
All good.
All good, and it looks yummy. Bought so we could have a little view while we eat our food. Venice Beach.
You ready to brave the wild?
I am. Let's do it.
Let's go.
These are what the lines are like in LA to get to the Trader Joe's.
Grocery shopping is complete. Back home we go. So we just finished grocery shopping. We got so much stuff. We spent like $300, which we never do. And now we're gonna head home and go to the beach. It's a beautiful day. We got some fresh flowers in the bag. It's important to have some nice flowers at home right now, especially since there's nowhere to go. So you wanna make your house feel nice and pretty. Anyways, headed home, finished grocery shopping, and now we're just gonna chill and relax. Oh, and also the grocery store line like was so long, but it was actually way quicker than we expected. So we were in and out within like an hour probably.
Yeah, it wasn't bad.
It wasn't too bad.
They actually had a lot of food.
And they had a lot of stuff finally before it was like scarce. There was like nothing left, but they have everything in stock in LA right now in Santa Monica. So that was nice and pretty easy.
Down to the beach. My neighbor brought me some sushi. So nice. And my beach boy is setting up for me.
That's all I'm good for.
That's all you're good for, beach boy.
It just got so windy, but it's still so warm. And Nick is skimming some waves. I'm drinking a white claw. Happy Saturday! Happy Saturday, Nick! Of me and Nick's quarantine has been Carol Baskin. Whacked him. Basically, if you've seen Tiger King, there's a song that came out on TikTok, and basically it's like the Savage song, but it's Carol Baskin version. So me and Nick laughed so hard because it's like Carol Baskin. Killed him, whacked him. And we always laugh so hard. You guys have got to see it. It's so funny. Carol Baskin killed her husband, whacked him. You have to see Tiger King to get it. Wearing my sweatpants on the beach, still quarantined. Sweatpant life. Maybe I'll go out in the sky, but it still feels a little too chilly. So cool, guys, because the bioluminescents are out right now. All this red algae that's here right now is bringing all this plankton and making it like bioluminescent activity happen in the water. So like when you have any kind of movement to it, it goes like, it like shows a light at night. Really, really cool. How do you explain bioluminescent, Nick?
Sure, it's when all the like plankton gets agitated and it makes bioluminescence color when it's agitated.
Yeah, so the water like goes like, bright.
Comes through.
And how often does it happen?
I think the last time was like, I'm not sure, like every 5 years or so. I know it happened in 2011.
There's like a bunch of red algae all out on the water.
It's not getting close enough into the shore to see it tonight, I don't think. Beer break.
Beer break? Beer over a kiss.
Beer kiss, kiss me.
Come up to the deck, and now there's no wind at all, so typical. It's now a beautiful day. I have my bucket hat on.
still in sweatpants, reading some magazines and eating our favorite bitch and sauce. And now it's a beautiful day again. I swear it's bipolar weather in Malibu always. This bitch and sauce is the best snack of all times. If you didn't know, now you know. You have to try them. They're vegan and so yummy. They're made out of almonds. So we're trying the chipotle and the pesto today, and we love these plantain chips from Trader Joe's. That is our afternoon snack. Came upstairs. We're gonna go have a fire downstairs. I got in some more comfies. And the sun just set. We're gonna have a fire down there. We're having a little fire on the deck. Playing some music. All right, we are out at sea.
Well, at least there's still air.
Checking out the bioluminescence. So dark. We're out here.
Yeah.
We out here. Wow, bioluminescent. Woo! It looks like there's lights on the bottom of the boat, but there aren't. This is literally just from the algae and the plankton lighting up when it has motion on it. So cool.
There you go.
Wow.
Have you played with it with your hands? It's so much fun. You gotta try it.
This is our Saturday tradition.
Or Sunday.
Or Sunday, either day. Nick is gonna open the mimosa.
Top off.
Hey, okay, alright, see it. Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's really stuck.
Oh, is it a bad bottle?
What?
You feel like you're in a reality TV show?
It's a nightmare.
Oh my God, seriously. Jesus.
I give up.
Babe, you gotta have mimosa, figure it out. It's coming, careful. Woo, oh my gosh, it worked. Not disaster, disaster. Vegan pancakes, and I use birch benders, and Nick has a chicken sausage, and it's time to feast. Our breakfast is served. Okay guys, so today is an explore day. We are going to, where are we going?
Poppy Fields!
We're going to the Poppy Fields. We brought a little picnic. And we are ready, Freddy, for the poppy fields. Let's hope we find some. I know some people said they saw a bunch. Some people said they couldn't find them.
We'll find them.
We are on a mish.
Got a mind on a money mish. And a money on the mind.
We got money on a mind.
And money means poppies.
And money means poppies. Hey, me and Nick abbreviate everything we say.
Okay.
So if we say mish or pop... We haven't abbreviated poppies yet, but we do say mish. Yeah.
A lot of people say mish, though.
But we abbreviate everything. Taco twos.
So cool.
We abbreviate. It's just our secret language. You'll see as we talk that we abbreviate everything. All right, off to the poppies. Eating a bar.
I loved it when you smiled. I loved it when you asked, can I stay a while? I can't believe I
did. Poppies are amazing. Like setting up our little picnic.
I loved it when you laughed and you couldn't stop. I can't believe I heard you.
fun. We stayed our distance from people. And we saw the puppies. We had a little picnic. It was so fun. And now back to Los Angeles. Bye, puppies.
We just left the Antelope Valley Poppy Reserve. The actual reserve was closed, but it didn't really matter because puppies are around there anyways. So we got to see all the poppies. It was so relaxing and fun, and I definitely suggest anyone who is in LA to go check it out because it's a really cute little quarantine activity to do, to get out and be in the nature, and no one's really there. We only saw a few other people, so I definitely recommend it. And now we are heading home, gonna go spend the afternoon on the beach, and then probably gonna barbecue tonight. So that's our Sunday. Say to me, Nick.
Michigan.
Wait, no. Oh no, our handshake. This is our handshake. No! Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished.
I'm gonna go head down to the beach and meet Nick. He's probably already set up down there. It's a beautiful day. Let's head down. It's our little beach spot. Nick's about to go in. He's got his board. And it's a beach day. Sun is shining. In and out marine layer all day today and all day yesterday, but we are enjoying what we can get. The reason why we're on the beach during quarantine is because we live in Malibu and we're extremely blessed that we have a private beach. So we are allowed on it. It's really saved us during this quarantine, being able to have it. So that is the reason we're still on the beach. We are 100% social distancing because, as you can see, we are the only people here. So stay home during this time. I know it sucks, and I definitely am really blessed to be able to have this, and I know people don't, so do what you can, and soon all summer we'll all be able to go down to the beach all the time, and that'll be amazing. And Mouse, do you agree, Mouse? He agrees. It's my neighbor's dog. So yeah, that was my little 2 cents for the day. Right, Mouse? Quarantine hopefully will be over soon. Let's pray. There's some random people next to us that just went in the ocean and took their trunks off.
I was not good.
I think they're European. They were tossing their trunks back and forth.
All guys, three guys.
Three guys, push-ups, and then jump in the water and toss their trunks back and forth.
By trunks, we mean underwear.
Oh yeah, they were underwear, they weren't even trunks. Sun is fully out. game of Scrabble now. Got the fire on. Sunset is looking insane. Wow. Favorite part of the day is always coming to see sunset. At the end of the day, usually Nick is surfing, or tonight we're just enjoying the sunset together, but we lucked out with a really beautiful one, so look at this, guys. Walnuts, our spices, our barbecue sauce, onions, black beans, soon our rice, and we're gonna make burgers out of it. Our vegan burgers are ready to go on. We are grilling up our vegan burgers with a veal. We've got our vegan mac and cheese, corn. I have my burger right here, vegan burger with these cauliflower thins. So good though. Good, right? Good morning, guys. It's another day in quarantine. I just got in my workout clothes. I'm gonna go do a workout down on the beach. I think I'm gonna film the whole thing and maybe put it up in a separate video or in this video. I don't know yet, but I'm gonna go do a workout on the beach and then make a protein smoothie probably, and then shower and get some work done. I have a call 11:45 with a brand that I'm working with, so kind of a busy day, and then I'm gonna try and shoot some content again around the house, but it's so difficult to. But yeah, the days go by like this. It's crazy. I like literally feel like it was just last week. It's insane. Anyways, yeah, let's get the day going. Just finished my workout, and I wanted to show you a quick and simple protein shake. So basically I do always collagen protein powder. And let's first put in some almond milk, just using this one. Mic is in the back working. So about that much almond milk. And then we are gonna do some, this is like a green smoothie. I love doing this one, it's just light, easy. So about like a bunch of spinach. Yeah, like that much. And then it says that you're supposed to do 2 scoops. So I will do 2 scoops of that for collagen and protein for after workout. And then I usually do frozen banana, but it's all I have right now. So I would do a full banana for this, but half does work. Also, if you just wanted to do half, that's totally fine. Your almond butter is a must in this because the spinach, you know, you kind of just like want to get rid of that, any flavor that's kind of harsh. So this should make it super yummy with some almond butter. Mine is just from the farmer's market. So any almond butter works. So it should look like this. And then I would put a few ice cubes in here also because it's not gonna be cold. So, cause the bananas weren't frozen. So I'd put like 4 ice cubes should be enough. And then the mystery is where my blender is. Nick likes to put the blender in a different spot every day. So it makes it real fun for me. Now, I'm going to use my NutriBullet and blend it. Did you hear that? I feel like it doesn't usually sound like that. Technical difficulties. Sorry, guys.
I think it's reached its final days.
That's great. All right, guys, sorry for the technical difficulties. We are back with a blender, so I'm gonna just pour it back in. My Nutribullet is officially dead, so that's great. But thankfully we had a blend that we completely forgot about that we even had, but here we go. Okay. And here is your yummy green smoothie. And I swear it is so good. I'm gonna put a straw in it. And voila. Protein smoothie for after a workout. So good. Guys, so tonight we are making we're making vegan nachos. I'm having plant-based meat. Nick is having regular part with onions, chili powder, and then put the meat in there. And then we do the same back there for the regular beef. And I just made some guacamole. Got our avocados out, Mexican night. Got the news on always. Avocado, cilantro, lime, tomatoes, salt, pepper, and a little dash of hot sauce, as well as garlic powder, and yeah. Oh my god, he just pulled them out. So yummy. We've got dairy-free cheese and siete tortilla chips. I think they're ready. Let's top the beef. And I'm gonna top them with my favorite, Tapatio. And then we're gonna finish with a Modelo. This is the best Mexican night ever. So Di Mayo today, I am down on my deck and my neighbors are having a little party just for all of our neighbors here, and we are all staying. We've only been with each other only, so we're not infecting each other or anything, so don't worry. But we have a taco truck guy that came and he's wearing his mask and his gloves, so we're definitely keeping our precautions. But now we were having some margs and getting the day going, and look at my hat. Happy Cinco de Mayo. What are we making over here?
We are making margaritas.
Margaritas.
It's the season.
Just a reminder, it's a Tuesday. Just in case you forgot, it's a Tuesday. It's a Tuesday. It's a Tuesday. Cinco de Mayo. Okay, good morning, guys. I was gonna make some banana bread with you guys. I am doing it with coconut flour and coconut sugar and my three ripe bananas. I've been making this like all quarantine because it's like so yummy and easy. You need a pan like this. And I have my oven already on, 350. I'm gonna combine my bananas. You need super ripe bananas, like these ones. 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Done. 1/4 cup of almond butter. Putting it in like a 1/4 cup measure. All right, that's probably good. Put that in. I need to mix these. I'm gonna use this thing. Makes it a lot easier. I'm going to stir. Next, it looks like you can either add regular eggs or flaxseed eggs. I'm now vegan, so I'm gonna try it with those instead. We've done the eggs, we've done the bananas, the vanilla extract. Now we're gonna add the flour. We're doing coconut flour, by the way. And it's 1/2 cup of coconut flour. Okay. And then next up is cinnamon, which we are out of. Pumpkin pie seasoning instead, because that's kind of like cinnamon. that works. 1/4 teaspoon salt, 1/4 tablespoon of baking soda. So I don't have an exact one, so I'm just gonna kind of guess. I feel like that should be good. I think that's everything. Now I'm gonna mix it all. Chocolate in it actually. I use this dairy-free WHO chocolate. Just added the chocolate chips and now it is going in for 15 minutes. So be right back in 15 minutes and I'll show you how it turned out. It's been about 35 minutes. I thought it was 50, but I double checked and it's only 25 to 35 for this recipe. And I got my bathing suit on because I'm about to go down to the beach. But I have to show you guys how it turned out. It looks so, so bomb. It's nice and crispy. And the taste test will be the true deciding factor if it's worth making or not. We're gonna taste it once it cools down and I'll let you guys know. Let's go try it. Let's see. Oh my God. So good and moist. You guys have to try it. I am getting a little bit exhausted with all of it. We just found out that we're gonna be in quarantine for 3 more months in LA, which is really crazy, but I think it's gonna be like a little bit of a looser quarantine of what it's been so far. It's been, you know, a lot kind of starting to get on us. We're really lucky we have the ocean, which I've said before, and like the beach by us, like that saved us. So I can only imagine how you guys must be feeling. But they have opened the beaches now in LA so you can work out and get fresh air, and that's super nice because we're going into phase 2 in LA. So it will open up, a few more businesses will open up, but it's still a stay-at-home order and you still have to wear a mask and it's still just gonna be like a whole different world. It's like not gonna be the same for a while, I feel like. So, yeah. How do you feel about it, Nick?
I'm over it.
You're over it. We're over quarantine for sure. But what are you gonna do? Do you wanna just keep pushing through and yeah, stay healthy. That's it for now, and I'll check back in later.